up everyone? Today we've met up with a viewer to check out his Mitsubishi Evo GSR. This is gonna be a pretty fun video. He's gonna go over all the specs on it. It's definitely been modified, so it's far from stock. We're gonna take a view around the outside first to see what we have going on.
Yeah, so I'm Jean, and this is gonna be my 12th Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution 10. Basically, it's a GSR 5-speed manual, and as soon as I got it, I started modifying it. So just to start out, exterior-wise, I did the Inky RPF ones. A lot of Evo 10s go with these wheels. They just work with the car, in my opinion. I went with a special blend color. It's like a black chrome. Wheel size is 18 by 9.5, and it's a 15 offset. Also went with wider tires, 265 by 35, obviously 18. Just wanted to give that extra little bit of grip, and just I like how it looks personally. So went with the wider tire and the RPF ones. I really do like the wheels. I just like how they look, and they are pretty light, so that's always a good thing for performance. The springs, it's called the Swift Spec R springs. Those are really made, they're not really made for looks. They do drop at about an inch, but as you can see, more than enough clearance. So what they're really made for is to make the car stiffer and just basically handle as nice as it can with springs without going coils. So pretty basic on that. I do have just a cheap plastic front lip. Just wanted to give it that extra little bit of look and flair. But that's really the only thing in this car that's not functional. Just wanted to give it a little bit of a touch there. Otherwise, outside, it's really bone stock. Really where this guy's modified is definitely gonna be in the motor and just
engine
performance.
Let's go ahead and pop the hood.
What's interesting is with these cars, when you pop the hood and you see what's underneath, you're not really gonna notice that much the difference between a stock one and that. If the only thing that's gonna give it away, if you actually zoom into here, that's gonna give you a clue of what it's running. So definitely the car is on flex fuel. It's running on E85, which if you have an Evo, please do. If you have the 85 near, you have to. It's great. It's really a good option. But as far as what's done to it, bolt-ons, you're going to have your upper intercooler piping. You have boost controller. You're going to have cab bag exhaust with a test pipe. No cats, because no one likes cats. That's definitely not good. Just aftermarket filter and intake. And the most important thing is fuel system. For E85, you need to run bigger injectors if you go bigger fuel pump. So that's done to the car. And obviously a tune. This car was tuned by Chris Carby. He's a really popular Evo tuner. And I went actually all the way to Florida to get it tuned. But I mean, besides that, in the actual hood, you're not gonna notice that much. It does have an upgraded turbo as well. It has a FP MHI 18K, which is all the way there. You're probably not gonna be able to see it that much just because of the location. It's a pain to change turbos on these cars. It's ridiculous. Previous Evos had it right in the front, so it's really easy. Evo 10 has it all the way there, so it's terrible to change it, but it's all good. It was done. Besides that, let's see what I'm missing out.
What's the total horsepower and torque?
So to the wheels, it made 427 wheel horsepower and 397 torque.
How much is that over stock?
Stock, they usually dyno around 250. So it's a pretty good upgrade.
Okay.
Stock.
Wow. We're almost 200 over.
It's a stock internal. So what I like about the Evos is as long as you have a good tuner, these cars are known to take the power. So that's just really why I went with the Evo platform. I just like the all-wheel drive, the all-around car, and it's a lot of power for a stock engine. If we go inside to the car, one of the most important mods you have to do if you have the Evo, definitely the recaro seats are awesome, but you need a pillow. Because if you're more than 5'10 or 5'8, you're going to get cramps and your lower back is gonna hurt. Now, I do have one thing that looks good on this car. It's my pillar for the gauge pods. The reason being is I installed that myself. Only part I installed myself. You can tell, it looks terrible, but it's all good. I have my wideband and my boost gauge that basically tells me how the engine's running, how much boost I'm pushing, and if I'm about to blow up the car or not. So that helps out.
For sure.
But besides that, I mean, that's really most of the modifications. The next thing is just actually driving and experience, you know, what the mods do to an Evo like that.
All right, well, I think it's time to go for a drive, see how that power gets put down.
So I've driven the bone stock MR with the 6-speed paddle shifting.
I've been in one GSR. It didn't have an upgraded turbo, so it probably wasn't making as much horsepower.
So let's hop in the Evo 10, check it out, and see if everybody's right saying the Evos are one of the coolest all-wheel drive cars. Let's see if they're that awesome.
So what kind of
of exhaust do you have?
It is, it's called a Manzo exhaust. It's actually a pretty inexpensive exhaust you can find on eBay. I took like one of the only parts I didn't really, all of the parts you see under the hood, they're all really nice and brand, but the exhaust, I figured it's just piping, I'm gonna put it in. Actually, a lot of people tell me, what kind of exhaust does it have? It actually sounds pretty decent when accelerating, and they're like, just cheap eBay 3-inch exhaust. Fun because you want to get the thrill out of you, you want to get the adrenaline pumping, and you just, okay, let's do a couple pulls, and then you're good to go. So it wakes you up.
The clutch, yeah.
Oh yeah, so it is aftermarket clutch. It's definitely on the heavy side, so it's not hard to drive. It's just you gotta, the biting feels gonna be about the middle, and it definitely has its weight. So because the stock one was not gonna hold up, it's probably gonna go boom. So definitely upgrade the clutch. But drivability, though, I mean, it's really easy to drive. If you just want to cruise around, you can cruise. It's pretty stiff. You can feel definitely bumps if there's a lot of bumps and stuff. But I personally like it.
I mean, it's smooth right now.
Yeah, you can definitely. It's daily driving.
Yeah.
On a good road like this, especially, it's more than fine.
And it's your daily.
It's my daily. I put 15,000 miles in under 6 months. So keep on straight, right?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. That's twice as many as I've put on the Lotus. Yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah, I like to drive. I mean, it's pretty reliable car, no issues so far. I mean, if you could have a good tuner that knows what they're doing and you pick out the right parts, there's really nothing to worry about. These cars are pretty nice for just daily driving. Mild turbo upgrade. It's not a huge turbo, it's just a little bit bigger. And E85 made the biggest thing. So on 93, this car made 380 wheel horsepower, and then we put some E85 and 427, so it bumps it up quite a bit.
Wow,
it's just part of it.
All right, setting off in the Evo. First time in a manual Evo, so that is always a cool thing. So far, clutch is a little heavy, but not bad at all. Makes a lot of noises so far.
It's a little louder from the back seat.
Yes.
You're closer.
Yeah, it's got some power to it. No doubt, a little bit of turbo lag, but once you get, I'd say, like 4,000 RPM, it starts really moving. That was just a second gear pull, and once it hits, that really hits.
Stinger. Wow.
It's fun being in the backseat, too.
Yeah, not often can we get a backseat of a sports car.
Yeah. Do you ever get wheel spin?
Honestly, I kid you not, I've never had it.
No?
Never. Even on the rain, like, if you have the traction control on, it kind of limits the power, but I've never had any issues with wheel spin at all. It's just traction everywhere. Especially the wider tires, I think, help a lot, too.
Well, that's true.
So there is,
you don't need to go with such a heavy clutch. It's just I wanted a clutch that, you know, you if I want to go 600-700 wheel horsepower, it'll take it. And I got used to it.
Especially if you're okay with it while we have a Prius up front.
So, but it's definitely, driver, as a daily driver, no issue so far. It's been pretty reliable. The only thing, if you're running E85 and it's really cold out, like really cold starts are going to take probably a couple tries. Like this car probably takes 3 tries in a really cold start. And if it's a hot day, maybe 2, but it's just, it's E85. That's just the way it is. It's normal. Yeah. Every person that runs an E85 knows about that. It's a flex fuel system, so basically it has a sensor where if you put some 93 on it, it changes the map. That way you don't run too lean or too rich. It's just good. It takes out timing, so you lose power if you put 93. But you can do a road trip if you want. You want to go to California, put 93, go all the way there. You can still have fun. It's just not going to have as much power.
So we just got back in our ride in this over 400 horsepower Evo. That was insane. That was an awesome ride.
Pretty impressive. A small 4-cylinder engine pumping out 427 at the wheels. And the 5-speed manual, you were all right. It is definitely a pretty awesome choice compared to the 6-speed. The paddle shifting is fun, but with the manual, you can experience the power.
So that was an awesome car. Thanks for inviting us out to check out your awesome Evo. Yeah. It's been one of my dream cars, honestly. I've always wanted to own one, so it was awesome to be able to check it out in person, go over all the mods that he's done to his car. It's super clean, very nice build.
Yeah, at the end of the day, I mean, I think what's special about it is that it's very attainable by most people. You know, it's something you can, if you desire it, you can absolutely save up, and definitely it's not a really hard thing to do. Again, you can get one of these used for mid-20s, and mods only had to run $4,500 to $5,000 in performance mods, so it's definitely something you can do.
So we hope you all enjoyed that video. If you did, be sure to give us a high five and subscribe, like our Facebook page, and follow us on Instagram.
Give it a like if you enjoyed it. Evo 10, what's not to like? So give it a thumbs up. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next video.